أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Closer and closer to mankind comes their reckoning, yet they heed not and they turn away. Never comes aught to them of a renewed message from their Lord, but they listen to it as in jest. Their hearts toying as with trifles. The wrongdoers conceal their private counsels, saying, Is this one more than a man like yourselves? Will you go to witchcraft with your eyes open? Say, My Lord knows every word spoken in the heavens and on earth. He is the one that hears and knows all things. Nay, they say, these are medleys of dreams. Nay, he forged it. Nay, he is but a poet. Let him then bring us a sign like the ones that were sent to prophets of old. As to those before them, not one of the populations which we destroyed believed. Will these believe? Before you also, the messengers we sent were but men, to whom we granted inspiration. If you realize this not, ask of those who possess the message. Nor did we give them bodies that ate no food, nor were they exempt from death. In the end we fulfilled to them our promise, and we saved them, and those whom we pleased. But we destroyed those who transgressed beyond bounds. We have revealed for you, O men, a book in which is a message for you. Will you not then understand? How many were the populations we utterly destroyed because of their iniquities, setting up in their places other peoples? Yet, when they felt our punishment coming, behold, they tried to flee from it. Flee not, but return to the good things of this life which were given you, and to your homes, in order that you may be called to account. They said, Ah, woe to us, we were indeed wrongdoers. And that cry of theirs ceased not, till we made them as a field that is mown, as ashes silent and quenched. Not for idle sport did we create the heavens and the earth and all that is between. If it had been our wish to take just a pastime, we should surely have taken it from the things nearest to us, if we would do such a thing. Nay, we hurl the truth against falsehood, and it knocks out its brain, and behold, falsehood does perish. Ah, woe be to you for the false things you ascribe to us. To him belong all creatures in the heavens and on earth. Even those who are in his very presence are not too proud to serve him. Nor are they ever weary of his service. They celebrate his praises night and day, nor do they ever flag or intermit. Or have they taken for worship gods from the earth? Who can raise the dead? If there were in the heavens and the earth other gods besides Allah, there would have been confusion in both. But glory to Allah, the Lord of the throne, high is he above what they attribute to him. He cannot be questioned for his acts. But they will be questioned for theirs. Or have they taken for worship other gods besides him? Say, bring your convincing proof. This is the message of those with me and the message of those before me. But most of them know not the truth, and so turn away. Not a messenger did we send before you without this inspiration sent by us to him. That there is no God but I, therefore worship and serve me. And they say, Allah most gracious has begotten offspring, glory to him. They are but servants, raised to honor. They speak not before he speaks, and they act in all things by his command. He knows what is before them and what is behind them, and they offer no intercession except for those who are acceptable, and they stand in awe and reverence of his glory. If any of them should say, I am a god besides him, such a one we should reward with hell. Thus do we reward those who do wrong. Do not the unbelievers see that the heavens and the earth were joined together as one unit of creation? Before we clove them asunder, we made from water every living thing. Will they not then believe? And we have set on the earth mountains standing firm, lest it should shake with them. And we have made therein broad highways between mountains, for them to pass through. That they may receive guidance. And we have made the heavens as a canopy, well guarded, yet do they turn away from the signs which these things point to. It is he who created the night and the day, and the sun and the moon. All the celestial bodies swim along each in its own rounded course. Granted not to any man before you permanent life here. If then you should die, would they live permanently? Every soul shall have a taste of death, and we test you by evil and by good, by way of trial. To us must you return. The unbelievers see you, they treat you not except with ridicule. Is this, they say, the one who talks of your gods? And they blaspheme at the mention of Allah most gracious. Man is a creature of haste. Soon enough will I show you my signs. Then you will not ask me to hasten them. They say, when will this promise come to pass, if you are telling the truth? If only the unbelievers knew the time when they will not be able to ward off the fire from their faces, nor yet from their backs, and when no help can reach them. Nay, it may come to them all of a sudden and confound them. No power will they have then to avert it, nor will they then get respite. Mocked were many messengers before you, but their scoffers were hemmed in by the thing that they mocked. Say, who can keep you safe by night and by day from the wrath of Allah most gracious? Yet they turn away from the mention of their Lord. Or have they gods that can guard them from us? They have no power to aid themselves, nor can they be defended from us. Nay, we gave the good things of this life to these men and their fathers until the period grew long for them. See they not that we gradually reduce the land in their control from its outlying borders? Is it then they who will win? Say, I do but warn you according to revelation, but the deaf will not hear the call, even when they are warned. If but a breath of the wrath of your Lord do touch them, they will then say, woe to us, we did wrong indeed. We shall set up scales of justice for the day of judgment, so that not a soul will be dealt with unjustly in the least. And if there be no more than the weight of a mustard seed, we will bring it to account, and enough are we to take account. In the past we granted to Moses and Aaron the criterion for judgment, and a light and a message for those who would do right. Those who fear their Lord in their most secret thoughts, and who hold the hour of judgment in awe. And this is a blessed message, which we have sent down. Will you then reject it? We bestowed aforetime on Abram his rectitude of conduct, and well were we acquainted with him. Behold, he said to his father and his people, what are these images to which you are so assiduously devoted? They said, we found our fathers worshipping them. He said, indeed, you have been in manifest error, you and your fathers. They said, have you brought us the truth, or are you one of those who jest? He said, nay, your Lord is the Lord of the heavens and the earth, he who created them from nothing, and I am a witness to this truth. And by Allah, I have a plan for your idols after you go away and turn your backs. So he broke them to pieces, all but the biggest of them, that they might turn and address themselves to it. They said, who has done this to our gods? He must indeed be some man of impiety. They said, we heard a youth talk of them. He is called Abram. They said, then bring him before the eyes of the people, that they may bear witness. They said, are you the one that did this with our gods, O Abram? He said, nay, this was done by, this is their biggest one. Ask them if they can speak intelligently. So they turned to themselves and said, surely you are the ones in the wrong. Then were they confounded with shame. They said, you know full well that these idols do not speak. Abram said, do you then worship besides Allah things that can neither be of any good to you, nor do you harm? Fie upon you and upon the things that you worship besides Allah. Have you no sense? He said, burn him and protect your gods if you do anything at all. He said, O fire, be you cool and a means of safety for Abram. Then they sought a stratagem against him, but we made them the ones that lost most. But we delivered him and his nephew Lut, and directed them to the land which we have blessed for the nations. And we bestowed on him Isaac, and as an additional gift, a grandson, Jacob, and we made righteous men of every one of them. And we made them leaders, guiding men by our command. And we sent them inspiration to do good deeds, to establish regular prayers, and to practice a regular charity. And they constantly served us and us only. And to Lut too, we gave judgment and knowledge. And we saved him from the town which practiced abominations. Truly they were people given to evil, a rebellious people. We admitted him to our mercy, for he was one of the righteous. Remember Noah, when he cried to us aforetime, we listened to his prayer, and delivered him and his family from great distress. We helped him against people who rejected our signs. Truly, they were a people given to evil. So we drowned them in the flood altogether. And remember David and Solomon, when they gave judgment in the matter of the field, into which the sheep of certain people had strayed by night. We did witness their judgment. Solomon, we inspired the right understanding of the matter. To each of them we gave judgment and knowledge. It was our power that made the hills and the birds celebrate our praises with David. It was we who did all these things. It was we who taught him the making of coats of mail for your benefit. To guard you from each other's violence, will you then be grateful? It was our power that made the violent, unruly wind flow tamely for Solomon, to his order, to the land which we had blessed. For we do know all things. And of the evil ones were some who dived for him, and did other work besides, and it was we who guarded them. And remember Job, when he cried to his Lord, "Truly distress has seized me, but you are the most merciful of those that are merciful." So we listened to him, we removed the distress that was on him, and we restored his people to him, and doubled their number, as a grace from ourselves, and a thing for commemoration for all who serve us. And remember Ismail, Idris, and Dhul-Kifl, all men of constancy and patience. Admitted them to our mercy, for they were of the righteous ones. And remember Dhul-Nun, when he departed in wrath, he imagined that we had no power over him, but he cried through the depths of darkness, "There is no God but you, glory to you, I was indeed wrong." So we listened to him, and delivered him from distress, and thus do we deliver those who have faith. And remember Zechariah, when he cried to his Lord, "O my Lord, leave me not without offspring, though you are the best of inheritors." So we listened to him, and we granted him Yahya, we cured his wife's barrenness for him. These three were ever quick in emulation in good works. They used to call on us with love and reverence and humble themselves before us. And remember her who guarded her chastity, we breathed into her of our spirit, and we made her and her son a sign for all peoples. Verily, this brotherhood of yours is a single brotherhood, and I am your Lord and cherisher. Therefore, serve me and no other. But later generations cut off their affairs of unity, one from another. Yet will they all return to us. Whoever works any act of righteousness and has faith, his endeavor will not be rejected. We shall record it in his favor. But there is a ban on any population which we have destroyed, that they shall not return. Until the Gog and Magog people are let through their barrier, and they swiftly swarm from every hill, then will the true promise draw nigh of fulfillment. Then behold, the eyes of the unbelievers will fixedly stare in horror. Ah, woe to us, we were indeed heedless of this. Nay, we truly did wrong. Verily, you unbelievers and the false gods that you worship besides Allah are but fuel for hell. To it will you surely come. If these had been gods, they would not have got there, but each one will abide therein. There, sobbing will be their lot, nor will they there hear aught else. Those for whom the good record from us has gone before will be removed far therefrom. Not the slightest sound will they hear of hell. What their souls desired, in that will they dwell. The great terror will bring them no grief, but the angels will meet them with mutual greetings. This is your day, the day that you were promised. The day that we roll up the heavens like a scroll rolled up for books completed. Even as we produced the first creation, so shall we produce a new one. Promise we have undertaken, truly shall we fulfill it. Before this we wrote in the Psalms after the message given to Moses, My servants, the righteous shall inherit the earth. Verily in this Quran is a message for people who would truly worship Allah. We sent you not, but as a mercy for all creatures. Say, what has come to me by inspiration is that your God is one God. Will you therefore bow to his will in Islam? But if they turn back, say, I have proclaimed the message to you all alike and in truth, but I know not whether that which you are promised is near or far. It is he who knows what is open in speech and what you hide in your hearts. I know not but that it may be a trial for you, and a grant of worldly livelihood to you for a time. Say, O my Lord, judge you in truth. Our Lord most gracious is the one whose assistance should be sought against the blasphemies you utter.